Wonder, loneliness, elation, terror. There have been countless studies on the association of memory with strong emotional responses. The horror of that time that you were lost in the wilderness, alone. The joy of seeing your favorite band live for the first time. But movies. Movies are designed to simulate an experience which would lead one to the most extreme emotions humanly possible. They do so through blood-curdling plot twists, impassioned performances, dynamic sets, astronomical budgets, heart-wrenching character arcs, and yes, music. It is true, at times, that the most effective way for a movie to get its message across may be with the lack of a musical addition. YMS.org discussed this topic in his Best of 2008 Films video, where he showcased how The Dark Knight used a lack of music to signify the intensity of the action taking place. Every hit felt harder, every sound emphasized. This video, however, is to look into those moments in which music added that extra emotional pull. When you hear that, what do you feel? Loneliness? Loss? The Revenant is indeed about a fur trapper battling nature, dead set on revenge, in the wide open wilderness. The silence between chords lets them breathe that open air. There is beauty in it. The minimalist orchestration lends itself flawlessly to the isolation of our protagonist.
Yo-ho.
Here, I hear adventure, fun, and maybe a hint of danger. I feel inspired to go on a quest, and seeing our favorite pirates do just that over this tune is sure to fuel a good time. Even listening now, I can find myself drumming along on my desk. Undeniable enjoyment and inspiration, a call to action, bombastic and loud, the opposite of the previous song. But music does more than general emotions associated with the movies. There tends to be a phenomenon where we attach the song to the particular moment it is played in the movie. For example, I think of the final Zep at the end of Saw. Think of 1917's flare scene and the night window. Or Bathroom Dance from Joker. Of course, additionally, there's the concept of soundtracks in which songs not intended for use in the movie were pulled or grabbed from popular culture and placed into the film. There are endless examples of effective use of soundtracks, but in this video, I'm particularly focusing on songs written for the movie. But what about moments that define a movie with the music? Whiplash and La La Land do exactly that with both of their final scenes. Music guides the final 7 minutes or more of each with essentially zero dialogue, and more is said at times than in entire movies. And, of course, subjectivity is involved in any form of art consumption, considering the fact that I would consider myself a musician. Both of these films spoke to me undeniably. The highs and lows found in these musically driven finales is an entire film in itself. It's important to remember the significance of the instrumental selection in creating the perfect atmosphere. You may have the perfect haunting melody, but played on a trumpet, it would not have the same effect as a piano. Take the Harry Potter theme, or prologue, by John Williams, for example. The mysteriousness of the instrumentation reinforces the aura surrounding the film and the school. I also love the detail of strings that sound as though they are flying around, as there is a lot of flying within the Harry Potter films. Or take Mr. Mustafa from the Grand Budapest Hotel. The quirky instrumental choices complement the quirky melody and accompanying film splendidly. Additionally, by playing on our cultural perceptions and archetypes, we can infer information without saying a word. For example, in Lord of the Rings, if you listen to the beginning of Concerning Hobbits, you may be inclined to believe that the theme may not be associated with an individual who is keen on going on wild adventures. The classical instrumentation would be likely associated with individuals more likely to stick to themselves, as hobbits do. Though, there is a hint of adventure in the middle section with a sweeping string part that hints of what is to come.
Don't open the door!
See? Everything's okay.
But what about those truly terrifying moments? The moments that keep you horrified for the entire night, checking your dark hallways to be sure that you're still alone? Well, a lot of those tend to be more just sounds with modern horror than actual music. But a dark atmosphere can definitely be created effectively with music. It Follows does this pretty well with tracks like Detroit. Isolated, dark, maybe even sinister, definitely effective. A lot of these songs are in the instrumental vein, but there are movie songs that play more like singles from a legendary artist, following a typical song structure, yet still fit within the movie. Sometimes these songs can transcend the movie because they're too good, but I think both of these examples are phenomenal individually as well as in the movie that they're presented. This is the end.
You got a friend in me.
With all of that said, here are a few other movie scores that really stuck with me over time. Let me know some of yours below.
Skies full of stars, raindrops on roses,
and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings.
Thank you so much for watching to the end, guys. The last video I did like this, on repetition and music, actually had all of the money claimed by Miranda Sings' cover of the short clip of the song that I actually was showing. So please support me in any way you can by liking the video, subscribing, turning on the notification bell, sharing with people, and potentially donating to my Patreon if you're interested. I hope to make more videos like this in the future, and thank you all for watching again. See ya.